Today in this class, we discuss the VVA macro power programming. In the VVA macro programming, we discuss the one project depend on the seed tab. Because in the last classes, we discussed about the seed tab.
Okay.
So today, discuss the seed tab. So I have I want to create the tab just like this project depending on the last project. In the last project, we discussed the create the file folder depending the our dates, the like year, month, and day. Remember, sir?
Yeah, I remember.
And today I have also created the file, but in the file have a seeds. Like I want to download the data the monthly. Right, sir?
Okay.
In the year 2018, and I have download the complete Jan to December data. Okay. So I have first created the one folder. First in the D drive. Right click and create the one folder 2018. And in the folder, I have created the 12 file Jan to December. Right, sir?
Yeah.
And 2018. And in this folder, I have created the 10 file Jan to December, and every file have a seed depending the date. Just like January, in the January file have a 31 sheets. In the February file, I have created the 28 and 29 sheets. So we have need the 365 number of seeds, but he's the arranged in the month wise file. Mm. Understand project?
Yeah. Yeah.
So let's start and create this project. please start the recording. I allow. Please start the recording. No, you can join from mobile phone, so you can't just record. Okay, I will record.
Okay, share me after half an hour.
Okay, thank you. Create the subject, and we first we have write the year folder. So we have MKDIR. You also know we have discussed the last classes.
Mm-hmm.
2018, right? So first we create the 2018 folder, and now we have add the workbooks dot.
Just I'm unable to see that screen.
Now what are now showing?
Just blank, like.
I think problem in your side. No visual?
No.
Okay, one second, wait. Now you see?
No. Yeah, now
So workbook.add.saveAs. And name is, look, path is that. In this path, we have save slash jan.xlsx, right? So we have need the code for the 12 file we create. So write the 12 code like this. And every line we have changed the file. This is the manual method, right? But now here is the 12 file creation. So you can write the 12 line of code. But maybe you have sometime you have one to the 100, 200, 300 number of line code for the repetitions. So we have, if you have a same code, but some initial change and you want to repeat the code the 100 times and many times, that time we use the loop. So we have write the loop for I equal to 1 to 1 to 12. So and next I. So I 4 is the your loop. And next is the your end line of the loop. And I is your counter. Your for loop, how many times will be run? Because next, before the next time running, next will be checked how many numbers are stored in the I. And number stored in the I have greater than 12. If greater than 12, then stop the loop.
Okay.
So I is the counter, just like variable x, y, z. And just the last classes, we have suppose that x, y, z and ymd like that. So we have, but I have created the file, but different name. Path is the same, but everything same, but we have difference with name. First the Jan, second the file. So I have stored the number on the I, 1, 2, 3 like. So here is use I is your file name as a file name. But file name is the 1, 2, 3, but number is the 1, 2, 3, but I want to file Jan, Feb, March. So I have the one formula, the month name. In the month name, you have entered the number and this.
I.
All right. Enter the I and number also. So convert to the month name, Jan, Feb, March. Right, sir? So numbers stored on the one by one, numbers stored on the I, just the first time run your loop, numbers stored on the I, and I have created the month name, convert one to January, and created the January file. Next time run the I stored as a 2, and month name convert to 2 to February, like that.
Okay.
It is clear?
Clear.
But in the one file, I want to create the seeds. So we have also created the seed and also rename the seed 1 to 30. Just like that, we have add the 31 seed and rename the 1, rename the 2, like that. So first, I have created the number of seeds depending the days of month.
Okay.
But how can calculate ki how many days in the month? Because I have the 12 month and every month will be changed. Just like January 31, February 28, 29, March also 31, April 30, different numbers. So in Excel, I have the formula. Say I have created the one date and I have the formula EO month and give the comma 0, you can get the last date of this month. And you can want to last day of month, so you can also apply the formula days. The days, I know the days formula support the VVA because last time we used, but EO month formula, I don't know if this formula support in the VVA and not support the VVA. How can I identify? So let's apply. When we apply the EO month formula, Here, open the bracket, there is a no expression. Hello line expression is not coming. It means this formula not supported in the VVA. Because Excel formula, who Excel formula you have applied here, and open the bracket, you can get the yellow line is expression. It means this formula supported in the VVA. This formula also supported in the normal action and supported in the VVA. But your month is not supported in the VVA. So this formula not supported in the VVA, we apply the we call the from the office library. So first we have calculated the date, because I have the only for the month, right? So apply the, you can also apply the one variable that's like dim d as a date. So I have created the one location in the our system, name is a d, and I store the data as a date. So d equal to, I have applied the one dash, and you apply the I, and also apply the dash 2018. So I have the I have the created one date, because I have only for month, I know the year, and one is the fixed. So I have created the one date, starting of the date of the every month, one by one. Just like first time I 1, so Jan, second time I 2, so Feb. Now we have just like last date LD equal to day. In the day, I will apply the formula EO month. Application dot worksheet function. I called you. We have which formula not supported in the VVA, we called to function library. So this is a function library path. Application dot worksheet function dot EO month. And here they apply the formula. This is our start date, comma is the zero. So EO month calculate the last date of the this created date, and day is the extract the only for days. That's like 31, the 31, and store on the LD. And now we have created the formula. So yeah, right here, work books dot add. How many work books dot? I want to create the sheet now. Sheets dot add, and there is the count. C O U N T count, and equal
ID
LD, but LD is the 31, but problem is that I want to number of seed according the month, but when you create the new file, default 1, 2, 3 seed already available. So if you write here only for LD, that time 31 to 32 to 34 seed created. If your file default seed is the 1, then 32 seed created. And if your file will be default the 3, then 34 is created. So have right here LD minus seeds.com.
Okay.
So we have subtract the number of which number of seed already added default the file minus from the last LD, the key last day, and we have created the sheet. And now we have renamed the name, and also problem key, we have the 31, 28, 29, 30 different sheet, the different months. So we have applied the also one loop again for J equal to, I have not used the I, because I use here. So we have used the new character J equal to 1 to LD, right? Next J. And sheets name, sheets, and right here J dot name equal to J. So what is the J? J is the number. First time one, it means first seed. First index seed created. I have also discussed the study last classes, Saturday classes. if you three way of the calling the sheet, first sheet caption name, second sheet property name, and third is the sheet index number, the position number. If your sheet is the position number first, then one, position number second, then two. So one by one, as per position, sheet activated and rename the as per your sequence. And after that, right here, active workbook dot save save. Right? And active workbook dot close. Right, sir. So this file only for save, because I have this inserted the sheets. So this file, the save, just like control S, and after that close the file. And again run the loop, again create the new file, and again create the date, and again last date of the month, and sheet added, and rename the sheet. And this code will be run the 12 times by for loop. So let us start and try. Macros run. And you can see here the your screen updated, right, sir? When the your macro will be performed, then your screen will be updated. You want to not update my sheet, just like hang the sheet and after the completing so, just like other feature work. So you can also use the code application dot this screen updating equal to false. After then you cannot get the screen updated. If which file open, which file close, not so. And you can see in the our folder, 2018 folder is created. In the 18 folder, we have created the file. And see here, is the month name is the full. This March is the full, not a short month name, because we have used the month name formula, and month name formula, we have applied the false. If you apply the false, then get the month name is the true, or full month name. And if you give the false, then short name, like here, by item. See, right? Yeah. File be created, every file. So I have see here, I see you, send you. Here is it. We have applied the false. It means the full month. Full month is, month name is the full. It's like January, complete January. If you apply a true, then your month name will be short. It's like Jan, Fe, Feb. Understand, sir? And I want to don't show the screen update, then apply your formula application dot screen update. Updating equal to false. Now your screen will be not updated, and you can also see here. Yeah, right. 1, 2, 3, 9, 20. Every sheet will be created.
I'm not able to see.
Now you can see my screen?
Yeah.
So every sheet will be created. You can try, I have sent the mail of this code. You can try this code on your PC, and you can also change as per your requirement, and you can apply here. And tomorrow we discuss about the range. Our third object is the range. A range is very important, because we have every work on the range. You can apply the filter, use the range. You can copy the data, use the range. You can pivot, apply the pivot, use the range. Apply the chart, use the range. The range is very important, because our data save on the range, and every work perform on the range. So range is a very big object. So we have read the part by part, the range, two and three classes. So today I send the mail, this code, and tomorrow we discuss, because next batch is the time, 7:15. So
at what time our class? For daily 45 minutes, right?
45 minutes. You can join the 6:30 and class over to 7:10 to 7:15.
Okay.
Okay. So you can send me the confirmation around 6:25. So we have take the 2 and 3 minute time for the sending the mail. Send confirmation. Okay. Okay. Bye. See you tomorrow. Same time.